The following is a special presentation of Conifer Radio, our continuing series of Conifer Podcast. Conifer Podcast presents the true life stories of our U.S. 285 corridor residents, their remarkable contributions to our community, and their encouragement to us all. We continue this week with the full board of the Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce in a Conifer Podcast recording from February 11th of 2021. Conifer Radio offers its support and gratitude to the Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce for its continuing leadership and contributions to our mountain community's welfare and vitality, and also as a founding supporter of Conifer Radio. Your new community radio station would not have been made possible without the Chamber's support.
Well, hello to our Bailey, Conifer, Pine, and U.S. Highway 285 corridor listeners, and welcome to another edition of Conifer Podcast. It is February 11th, and we are here live in Mobile Studio with the board directors of the Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce. With us tonight, please welcome the following: Mr. Matt Dombrowski, Board President; Ms. Jessica Bartuk, Board Vice President; Mr. Tim Gregg, Director of Area Development; Mr. Richie Frangiosa, Treasurer; Mr. Rob Green, Director at Large;
and Melissa Niebuhr, a Director at Large.
And lastly and not leastly, Mr. Jim Myers, a Director at Large. Not with us this evening, but here in spirit, is Dr. Sheila Rice Watkins and Mr. Josh Grady, who serves as secretary to the board. So by way of introduction, the Platte Canyon Chamber of Commerce is located in Bailey, Colorado, and most of us have enjoyed the area events sponsored by the Chamber, including Cowboy Christmas, Bailey Day, and our Gold Rush leafkeeping campaign in the fall. As a nonprofit organization, these folks are volunteers whose contributions cannot be understated. Without a local town government, these are the folks who get things done. And in addition, the Chamber is a founding supporter of Conifer Radio, and this community radio station's existence would not have been possible without their support. So folks, welcome to Conifer Radio and Conifer Podcast.
Thanks for having us here today, Mark.
We've got a large group and several topics to cover today. And so Mr. Matt and Mr. Richie, let's begin with you today. Your story as a Chamber of Commerce. Tell the local community a little about you and what prompted you to step forward to serve the Bailey Pine, Pine Grove, Grant, Shawnee, and surrounding areas.
Thank you, Mark. As you stated, my name is Matt Dombrowski. I am the president of the Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce. I started in chimney doctors in my house almost 20 years ago, and several years ago we decided to move to a brick and mortar location located in downtown Bailey. Me and my wife Crystal started the business and worked together in it. We also have raised our three children in the Platte Canyon area and school district. Originally, several years ago, I was approached by Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce to join and become a member. Shortly thereafter, I was asked to be a board director at large. A couple years after that, I became vice president of the chamber for several years, and now I am in my second term as president of the Platte Canyon Chamber. And I think what really intrigues me the most about this area is we have a tight-knit community, and I got involved because I do enjoy the community, and I felt it was a great way to give back.
And Richie, what would you have to add to that?
Hi, Richie Frangiosa here. I'm kind of the other end of the spectrum. I've lived all over the world throughout my life, and only came to Colorado about 6 years ago, and Park County about 4 years ago. But once myself and my family ended up in Park County, we knew this is where we were going to stay, and wanted to get involved with the community. And the chamber was an obvious way to do that. Joined as just a member a few years ago. Within about a year, I was basically told, "Hey, you're our new treasurer." So, you know, as I was also looking for ways to serve the community, it couldn't have come at a better time. And, you know, I just really enjoy having a part in being part of this community and doing the best we can as a chamber to try to promote and help everyone be successful.
Well, Tim Gregg, Mr. Gregg, let's continue with you. And what is it about the Platte Canyon Chamber and its presence in the region that's been important to the Bailey community and the surrounding area?
Hi, Mark. We've traditionally been a traditional chamber, I guess, that included things like education. We used to have a program called Platte Canyon University. We have business guests at our general meetings. We can inform our business owners, I should say. we try to get that information. We also put that information out to the public in any kind of information there. One of the great things that I've always considered with Chamber is the philanthropy that exists. Behind the scenes, the Chamber does give a lot of money to the local programs, and it's been something that I've been impressed with. Of course, we have always done business networking, events like Bailey Day, the car show, Cowboy Christmas, as you mentioned. We also have some collaboration with some other chambers in the area. We work with the Conifer Chamber a bit through the 285 Tourism and the 285 Improvements Group. We're looking at doing a few things differently now, though. We're looking forward at how we do things. New activities we're looking at is the addition of actually my role, the Director of Area Development. Under that, we've started with a Beautify Bailey program. We've got big plans to make Bailey more attractive to our visitors and even open up the river as we move forward. We also collaborate with the local authorities here. We're going to do that much more. The sheriff, the commissioners, the fire chief, people like that. And we then, you know, again, like we did in the past, is we pass that information out to the general public. We're also, in my role, I am going to be looking at long-term planning for the community and business opportunities. We're governed out of fair play and, you know, no city government here, as you mentioned. We really want to have fair play pay good attention to the Platte Canyon area. So we're going to look at doing some planning, working with commissioners in lockstep, working with people like CDOT, things like that. We're really excited about that. We're really excited about the changes we're looking at and the way things are going to be going forward.
We also have with us tonight Mr. Jim Myers of the Sasquatch Outpost. And Mr. Myers, we understand that you were the chamber president when your motto of Mountain Strong Together was developed. Tell us what this vision means and why it's important to our mountain communities.
Hey, Mark, thanks for the opportunity. Yes, we came up with this slogan kind of as a result of a lot of discussion on the board and with the chamber at the time, which is a number of years ago now, trying to figure out what our identity was as Bailey residents and as mountain residents. We actually came up with a couple of statements. The first one was Bailey by choice, which identified certainly for the Bailey residents, but didn't include the other towns in our Platte Canyon area. So we changed it to Mountain Strong Together. And the whole idea was to describe in a few sentences what we are or who we are as mountain people. And we, I don't know if you've ever seen any of the posters that we came up with that are in many of the local businesses that have the title Mountain Strong Together. And it just describes who we are, talks about us being hardworking and honest and energetic. And it's a number of qualities that we felt like described mountain people at our best. It was just an effort to find an identity. We used it actually on a sign that we put on County Road 43. It was up there for a number of years. It said, I believe, Bailey by choice, shop local, and Mountain Strong Together, all on the one sign, to try and help our people on that side of the highway anyway to remember that we do have a community and we do have businesses that need their support. So that's kind of the background of that Mountain Strong Together slogan.
And Jim, while you have the microphone, and others I think would want to jump in here, please tell us about the plans ahead for Bailey Day for June of this year.
We are going to have a Bailey Day, we hope. Everything is full steam ahead at this point. Obviously, last June, we had to cancel Bailey Day, which was a huge disappointment for everyone, because this is the one time of year that all of us, or the most number of people from Bailey, gather together for fun and friendship and networking and everything else that happens on Bailey Day. So we are full steam ahead. Our committee is very committed this year. We've got a good committee. We've got a bigger committee than we typically have. And that's always a good thing because we can divide up the responsibilities. We're heavily into the planning of the entertainment. Different ones of us are looking for vendors and sponsors. The main thing to say is Bailey Day will happen. It will be on June 19th, barring something unforeseen. We are hoping that there will be no conflict with the COVID regulations by that point in time and that Bailey Day can happen. And I don't know if anyone else would like to throw their words in on Bailey Day. I'm certainly not the only one working on the committee.
I'd like to add in, Mark, you know, for people that haven't ever experienced Bailey Day, I know there's a lot of talk of people turn left and go down the hill for everything. Bailey Day is a great time for people that aren't familiar with our downtown area and the rest of Platte Canyon corridor to come down, because it's a really good collection of our food that's available through the corridor, our retail shops, and a lot of our local artists and craftsmen. I encourage everyone, if they've never been, at least attend one, and you'll probably be coming back every year like the rest of them.
Thanks, Matt. And folks, we are here live in Mobile Studio again with the board of the Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce. And you can learn more about Bailey Day and also about the Platte Canyon Area Chamber at www.bailey-colorado.org. So let's move forward on to Rob and Melissa and have you both talk about something fun you've discovered about the U.S. Highway 285 corridor and Bailey community and what's fun and interesting about living and working up here.
Hi, this is Rob. I'll go first, Melissa. I've been in Colorado for 25 years now, the majority of it spent in Denver. And I've had my house up here for 7 years and have been living here full-time for over a year now. And what I've really come to love about the 285 corridor is the fact that you really don't have to go into Denver to get what you need, right? So I always joke about the fact that, you know, there's a coffee shop in Conifer, but they have the best teas and I drink tea. I never had a tea shop in Denver. You know, it was a place to go get our dog bones. What's really key is that they're all small businesses. So whether you're going to the brewery or you're going to the winery in Bailey, it doesn't take very long to actually get to know people in Bailey and along the 285 corridor. So it feels like a real community, which was a big shock to me, thinking that, like, oh my God, you know, we don't have all the big city stuff, but we in fact do. It's just smaller businesses, but they're run by people that you get to know, and it creates that whole sense of community.
Just to piggyback on that a little bit, you know, everything that Rob said, but for me, it's definitely the relationships that can be formed here that are so special. I mean, I think just being a small town, getting to know the owners of the small businesses, getting to know their stories and why they do what they do is pretty special. You don't find that everywhere. And sometimes it's hard to even meet the actual business owner of a business if you're in a larger town or city. I think also just, again, like being able to share experiences with the members of the community as a whole. It's so awesome to just be able to go to your local spots, the winery, the brewery, one of the restaurants, and, you know, have my son see a friend from kindergarten class. Mom, he's in my kindergarten class. Or, you know, meet up with somebody that you want to, I don't know, maybe you have some business stuff to talk about and you can just say, hey, let's meet up at the brewery. And it's a few minutes away for everybody. It's pretty cool. And then I know we all just really try to support each other here, whether it was just with COVID, just really helping out all of our local businesses and making sure that we were really focused on shopping there and more than maybe we usually did, and helping other families who are in need. It's a lot of our community Facebook pages really ask for help from the community. And we're, you know, it's so cool to see people step up. And then just the most interesting thing about our community is I think we have quite a few unique spots out here that I feel like Bailey's known for. If anyone mentions Bailey, these are usually the spots, and it's a Sasquatch Museum, Sasquatch Outpost. I never knew anything like this existed, and I've become a believer because of it. And it's always, you know, anytime someone visits, it's where we go. And then also Coney Island is a big go-to for the passerbyers. I think, you know, just driving through Bailey and seeing the big hot dog is a fun experience. And then the chamber events, Old West Fest, Bailey Day is super unique, and our Cowboy Christmas. I mean, I think that everyone does such a great job of just trying to keep it fun and spunky around here.
And Jessica, what have you discovered that's important to the non-business community organizations around here, the nonprofits, the churches, and being the representative of a nonprofit yourself?
Right. Thank you, Mark. So Speaking from my experience as an employee of a nonprofit, I think the support that the chamber provides to non-businesses are both direct and non-direct. So direct support can look like providing financial support to nonprofits who are serving the Bailey community, as Tim mentioned earlier. Some examples of the indirect support through the chamber is the platform they provide and the networking opportunities available. So attending and sharing at the chamber meetings, both in person and virtual, is a huge help. Non-businesses are able to share information about upcoming events and fundraisers. Also, emailing your information to be included in the chamber newsletter is an easy way to get your information to an even larger group. Networking with business owners and community leaders through chamber events can be a huge benefit. For me personally, being new to Bailey, that's really how I got myself involved in the community, was going to chamber events and getting to know other people in the area. So being a part of a nonprofit that is a member of the chamber, I can honestly say that the chamber has been a great resource for us, and I hope for other non-businesses in the area.
Well, Mr. Matt and everyone around the table today, metaphorically, as we close our discussion, what encouragements do you have for our community for the future of Bailey and the U.S. Highway 285 corridor?
Thank you, Mark. This is Matt again. I think I'd like the listeners to know that they have an amazing, energetic, intelligent group of people working hard for them in the board of the chamber. We are always working for improved community resources, improved fellowship amongst the community, promoting businesses, whether they are a home-based business or a brick-and-mortar store such as my own. I think as everybody listening today knows that the Bailey area is growing in size pretty dramatically, and we want to embrace that growth, help facilitate it, and give a re-energized downtown look to the Bailey area. I think I'd also encourage anybody listening today, if you haven't checked out the chamber, come to one of our meetings or attend a Zoom meeting and join the chamber. We have a great group of people. We're always looking for various volunteers in our subcommittees to put on promotions, productions, and the famed Bailey Day event.
This is Jim again. I would add to what Matt said that a lot of people find that Crow Hill is a demographic separator between the top of Bailey and quote unquote downtown area of Bailey. And we just want to encourage everyone from Conifer and the Bailey community who typically don't drive down Crow Hill to come on down, because there's so much to offer in Bailey now, in the bottom part of Bailey. The restaurants we have, the businesses, the amusement like the Treehouse Adventure Park, all these things are part of the new Bailey, I would say, and the growing Bailey. And we really have a lot to offer, and we're trying to create an environment that will be more conducive to people coming and just strolling up and down Main Street and visiting the businesses that we have to offer.
Well, thank you, Jim. And thank you to the rest of you as well. And on behalf of Bailey, Pine, Conifer, our U.S. 285 Highway Corridor Mountain communities, we want to recognize Matt, Jessica, Tim, Richie, Rob, Melissa, Jim, plus Sheila and Josh, who couldn't be here tonight, for their leadership and your contributions to the Bailey community. Conifer Radio is a proud member of the Platte Canyon Area Chamber of Commerce and also a proud supporter. So would all of you like to join me again here in the future, maybe in a couple months ahead as we approach the summer season, for another edition of Conifer Podcast?
Certainly.
Absolutely.
In a minute.
We want to get as many people to Bailey Day 2021 as we can. A lot of people in Bailey have not seen each other because of COVID, and it's a big day. So we want to get everybody out and about.
All right, then. Thanks again, folks. And there you have it. A good night to Bailey America, where we are all mountain strong together.
Thanks.
Thank you.